Well, hi-de-ho, Stampers. Deb Valder here, your fun Stampers Journey Coach. Today I want to highlight the Color Cross Bundle. It's a gorgeous stamp set. It has a beautiful cross and a bunch of religious sayings in it. It's called the Color Cross Bundle. It has a die that goes along with it that we're going to use today, which is in my little packaging right here. I'm going to take out the die. And I'm going to just show you a couple things that we can do with it. So the card that I'm going to highlight is this one right here. I want to show you two others that I have done, or I should say I haven't done. This one right here was done by one of my teammates. Her name is Barb Stomaronski. Very, very talented gal. She did this on vellum. She took and used our white embossing powder, and then on the back of it colored. It looks so Celtic and so beautiful. She did a beautiful job. She's a very talented artist. So that's one of them. And the other one is this one right here, and it's just all done with dies and that one stamp set. Used the sayings from the stamp set and then embellished. This is our brand new banana cream ribbon with the stitching on the outside. Love that. And then some really pretty embellishments. Again, done with the Color Cross bundle. So in the bundle you get, like I said, the cross, all of the sayings, so there's six stamps in the set, and then you also get the die to go along with it, so there's no cutting on it. For this card right here, what I did was I added the background to it, and that is this one right here. It's called Ornamental, I added this one right here, which is called Ornamental Medallion, and in the catalog, it has a stamp or a die that goes along with it, and that's the ornamental label. The two of these go together so well. Let me just show you what they look like together. So this is the Ornamental Medallion, and then underneath it is this one right here. Let me just show you the one I'm referring to. It's not the biggest one, it's the next one in. So that's the one I used for this background piece right here. So those are the dies that I used. Now on the yellow one, you'll notice that here I used the actual doily die that we have, and let me show you that one in the catalog. So to find the doily die, that one is on page, 251, and there's the doily die. But the other die is, let me just show you, it's on page, my little ribbons are my markers here. Almost there. Okay, so this is the die that I'm talking about. This is the ornamental die, ornamental medallion die. All right, try saying that one three times fast. And then the one right underneath it is the ornamental label die, and the two of these go together. So it's like peanut butter and jelly. You need them both. They go together. They're awesome. All right, one lays on top of the other, and that's the way it looks, just like this, okay? So those are the dies that I'm using, and I think we can get started now. So I want to show you how you can save paper, because you know I'm all about saving the paper also. Let me bring in my grid sheets so that I have something to work on. All right, and now we're going to just get going. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take my whipped cream layer. So that would be this layer right here, the top layer, and I'm going to stamp my my cross right on there. So let me just grab the stamp and the ink. Okay, here we go. And I use, this is one of my favorite blocks. This is the G block, and it's just a great size block, but I use this one a lot. I think this is one of my favorites, and it fits this this little guy really perfectly, actually. I'm using the River Rock, or the River Stone ink for this color. All right, I think it lends itself very nicely to it. And then I'm going to take the, just take and stamp it right on. Now what you want to do is make sure it's right dead smack in the middle of your paper, side to side, top to bottom, and I'll show you why in just a moment. All right, so there we go for that. Beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. So I took the Riverstone ink and I took my die, and that's what I stamped. And I stamped it right in the middle of that layer. And then what we're gonna do is to take and cut this out, but we also need to cut out the background right here. And there's several different ways that you can do this, depending on how you want to glue it on. All right, now it's glued right to this layer right here, but there's several different ways that you can do it. So let me just show you a couple of those. All right, so I'm gonna take my, just a scrap piece, but it's a, I actually used the big piece, so it's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, so it's a true 1/4 inch size, and that's gonna fit our die very nicely. Let me grab the die out of my little pocket right here, okay? So I'm gonna grab the die, and before I put it on here, for the first way I'm gonna show you how to do it, I'm gonna take some of our white liner sheets, and those are these right here. You get four sheets in a pack, just absolutely awesome stickiness to them. This right here has two sides to it. We're going to take off this side right here, and you're just going to take and grab the corner of it right here and pull them apart. Alright, so I'm taking off the white side right here. Okay, so I'm just going to take off the white side and throw that piece away. And I make these smaller than this piece right here on purpose, because we don't want it to hang off, because when we run it through our Amaze machine or our Journey Platinum, we don't want it to stick to the machine. So I make it just a little bit smaller. All right, doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to actually cut it out. Now, when I go to cut it out, I'm going to cut it out on this side because I want this to be the right side, obviously, and the stickiness will be on the back side of it, just like that. So that's one way we're going to cut it out, and I will do all the cutting at the same time. So that's one way we're going to cut it out, and I'll show you that in a minute. And then the other way is to take my dryer sheets, and I have a whole video on this. People just love this video. All right, I'm going to put the dryer sheet down, I'm going to put this on top, and then I'm going to put that on top, and we're going to glue it with our Journey Craft glue right here. All right, so let me just bring in my Amaze machine, and I'll show you the different ways that you can cut these out. All right, and they're both super ways to do it, just a little bit different. So I'm going to bring in my Amaze machine here, and let's do the dryer sheet one first, okay? So these are just inexpensive dryer sheets. I buy the no perfume, no dyes kind. If you use the perfume kind, it's really bad because there's a lot more sticky stuff that's in there, and we don't want that. And I'm just going to lay this on the top, just like that. And then I'm going to lay this on the top of that. And I'm going to grab my top sheet, my top platform right here, and just run it through. I have that grid paper underneath. Let's take the grid paper off because otherwise, see, this has it's really nice and tight, and it doesn't move all around without the grid sheet underneath it. All right, so there's one, and then before I show you how this is all going to come apart, I'm going to take and do the other one for you. All right, so now we have, where'd it go? Here it is, the one with the sticky sheet on the bottom, okay, and my paper on top. I'm going to grab this little guy right here, put it on. Remember, on the bottom of this is the white liner sheet and just a quarter sheet of cardstock. And then I'm going to add my top right here and run that through. And then what I'm going to do is take my platform and my cross with the die here and cut this out. Now, what you want to do is make sure that it's nice and centered, all right, side to side, up and down. Grab my top piece right here and run her through. Okay, so now I have all my pieces cut out, so all I have to do is put this aside. Bring back in all the pieces that I just cut, and we'll get together working on this, okay? Let's bring this back in, okay? And then we'll just start putting it all together. So let's grab our base, which is just a white base. It's 11 by 4 1/4, scored at 5 1/2. And then our next piece, okay, let's bring in the card so you know what I'm doing. The next piece is going to be this piece right here, actually, or let's see, there's a... Nope, sorry, there's a layer right here. Okay, so this one is 5 1/4 by 4, so that's going to be our next piece, but I'm not going to glue it on because I'm going to pop that one up. So I'm going to take that one, and then I'm going to take this piece right here, okay? That's going to be my next layer, believe it or not, okay? It's going to go right there. See how I saved paper? I love to save paper. And if you do it nice and in the middle, works out really good. And then my next layer beyond that is going to be one of these. So this is the one with the sticky sheet, and all I do is take this off like this, and that's how easy it comes off. And then I'm going to take that off, And then in order to take off this piece right here, you'll just grab your bloom tool and just scrape the end of it right here at the end, and it comes up, and all of this is just really sticky, all right? And then when you do that, you just lay it right on here. The other way that I did it, let me find it, is this one right here, and this is the one with the dryer sheet on it. So I'm gonna take and just lift this off like that, grab that part of it. What I like about this method is that all of the little, or most of the little pieces in here stay on the dryer sheet so they're not all over. Just running it through or whatever, the bad thing about that is that you have all these little pieces all over the place. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of take and bend this and grab. And you see how most of it stays right on there? Not all of it, but most of it stays right on the dryer sheet. These are good for all of your intricate dies. When you do it this way, it just makes it so much easier to get out. Just be careful because it is so detailed that you don't want to rip anything that you're not supposed to. So I just kind of bend it, and that leaves all of that stuff on there. Now, you can reuse the dryer sheets also, okay? And all I do is take these, I'm going to do it here, but I would do it over a garbage can, but all you have to do is take some of these off. You don't even have to take all of them off, just take the bigger ones off. And then you can reuse the dryer sheet this way. Then you can reuse the dryer sheet this way. So you get a whole lot out of these, and they're not that expensive. All right? So that's how I got these out of there. Now let me just poke out the rest of them right here, because it doesn't take all of them out, but it takes most of them. All right? And keeps them right on the dryer sheet. But it saves you so much time and mess. All right, and I would be normally doing this right over the garbage can. I just have a few of these little tiny ones right here that I'm just going to poke with my bloom tool and just get those out. I think there's four of these. I've done this so many times. I just love this die. I've done it so many times that I just know where we have. Now, people always ask me, this is different than this one. Is there an up and a down? I think there is. This to me looks like a little tulip. So to me, the single pointed thing with the two little things up there is the top to me, and this is the bottom. But that's totally up to you. I think that this looks either like a heart or like a little tulip. So to me, that's the up. To me, that looks upside down because of that. But like I said, that's up to you. Totally up to you. All right. So let's get these out of the way. And now that we've got all of those pieces cut out, we're good to go. All right, so I think we have everything ready to start putting it all together. But the first thing we need to do is to bring this back in, our little cross right here, to bring in our little cross. And I'm just going to show you how I colored. I'm all about being fast and elegant. So I'm going to show you how to color very fast and very elegant. Just take an old block, okay? Just take one of these old blocks. These are ones that don't have the grids on them, but you can take pretty much anything. If you have, always shake your re-inkers. Just take anything. You can put it on. You can even put it on a piece of aluminum foil and use that as your palette. But I like these blocks. So I'm taking my Fusion Blender. I'm just going to take a little bit of that because it really doesn't need a whole lot of anything. We're going to take this, shake it up, and I'm just going to use a little drop here. Okay. Alrighty, and then I'm going to take the large one. This is our large blending brush, and I'm going to take and first clean it, make sure it's all nice and clean, but I was using it to do these, so I do have a lot of the and this is Cool Pool, by the way. This is one of my favorite colors, Cool Pool. I love it, and love it with gray. All right, I'm going to pick this up, and rather than just like coloring, which you can do, all right, but to do fast stamping, watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to use the side of my brush, and I'm just going to color a little bit. Not in the same spots, just color a little bit here and a little bit there. I am going to color the whole flower. And the more Fusion Blender that you use, the lighter it's going to be. Now remember, this always dries lighter. So keep that in mind when you're putting your color on here, that it does dry a little bit lighter. You see, I didn't do the whole thing. I just did bits and spots. To me, that looks very Celtic. It just looks very pretty. It also brings in the colors of the rest of the card, the ribbon, and the coordinated cardstock. I love how everything just coordinates. Perfect. All right? And that's all there is to it. You could make a bunch of these for Easter, but this could be an Easter card. It could be a wedding card. It could be a baptismal card. That's what I love about the diversity of this little cross right here. You can use it for just about anything. Okay, now it's time to put everything together. So I'm going to grab my card base, And then I'm going to grab my cool pool piece, and I'm going to put some journey foam squares on it. So let me just grab my big ones. I think I'm going to use my big ones for this one. All right, so here's two of them. All right, one there, one there. Let me grab the next sheet. I love that there's no waste with these, you know, just you just pop them right on, no waste. All right, so there's those, and they're so easy to get these things off. And I'm not even going to take the middle one off because that's just a placeholder, all right? So that's going to get popped onto my card base as such. Okay, now we have the piece that we cut out, believe it or not, just like that, okay? And that's going to go directly on with my Easy Glide. So just take my Easy Glide, do a little bit here, and this stuff is absolutely fantastic, this Easy Glide. The lighter you go, the better it is. Don't press down a lot on it. You're going to just center this. We will never see that cross in the middle because of all the layers that we're going to put on it. Okay, so there's that. And now, remember I told you there's two ways to put this on. This is the one that came off the dryer sheet. Here's the one that came off with the sticky sheet, the white liner sheets. And remember what I said, I started it with my little bloom tool, all right? And all I'm going to do is just take this and just peel it. And when I do, this piece down here is very sticky. All right, so I'm not going to use that one. I'm going to use this one because I want to show you how awesome this Journey Craft glue is. Now, I'm not going to slather the whole thing. I'm just going to do bits and pieces of it. Okay, just little dots will do ya. All right, so maybe a little bit right there, a little bit there. And all I'm doing is just like taking like maybe the major corners and putting a little bit of adhesive on there. Okay, just like that. All right, perfect. Maybe one here. I don't even need this much. All right, that's how awesome this stuff is. I love, love, love that glue. All right, and now what we're going to do is we're going to lay that right over the top. And remember, I said there is a top and a bottom. I think there is. Okay, and I'm just going to lay it right down here. So far, it's, you know, like you're having a hard time seeing where we had that thing cut out, right? All right, so here's this, and then what I like to do is just lay it down, press it, okay? That makes it nice and flat, all right? And then we're going to add this little guy with our Journey Foam squares, okay? One here, and then on each corner here, okay? And pop these right off. This is such a beautiful stamp bundle. It is just such a beautiful bundle. No matter what you do with it, it comes out so elegant and so pretty. And what I'm doing is I'm literally covering up exactly where this came out. So I saved myself some paper, and it's just so easy to do. So now what I'm going to do is just embellish it. I have a couple of different things that I did. Here I put a pearl, and here I put one of our brand new candy drops. All right, so I'm going to take and use one of these. I'm just going to grab this out of my bag, and these are the brand new ones in the mini catalog. So I'm going to take my bloom tool and lift it up with that and put it right here in the middle. Okay, so far so good. Now on this one, I don't know if you can see it or not, but I used some of our Journey Splash, some of our silks. I used the Cool Pool. So on this one, I think what I might do is use the Cool Pool and, let's get these out of the way. I'm gonna use the Cool Pool and the silver. So the silver will pick up the gray and the Cool Pool will pick up the rest of the Cool Pool colors in the card, all right? So let's just dab a little of these on here. Get some more. Make sure you shake these before you use them because they do have that little BB on the bottom of it that really helps stir it up. And you want to do that because, especially like in this one, it's got some really pretty sparkles in it. And so when you put it down, it just looks so pretty. So this would be a monochromatic pretty much card because it's got mostly just the Cool Pool. All of the accessories that I'm working with also are the Cool Pool. You know, the little dot, the paper, the silk, they all just so coordinate so well. Okay, and last but not least, I'm going to use some of our ribbon, our Cool Pool satin ribbon, and I'm just going to make just a knot. So I just took about a 6-inch piece. Yep, just about a 6-inch piece. I'm going to take and I'm going to just make one little tie in it. All right, and then I'll grab my Grand Pro shears. I like to kind of put that ruching there in the middle. See that? I call that ruching. And there we go. And now I'm going to take my Grand Pro shears and just trim off the ends. All right, so there's one end. Here's the other end. I could have probably done this, I feel like, name that tune. I could have done this in 5 inches. All right, and then just grab my journey dot. Okay, so when you use these, make sure you leave, this is the bottom of the box, make sure you leave this on here, and when you go to do it, it just pops up just like that. And then you can tear it off and put it right onto your item that you need to put on. Okay, and then add that to your card. Ta-da! And that's what we have. Isn't that so pretty? Here they are, all three cards. This one right here, I did a little bit different than these two. These, I added the silks to them, and these little candy drops, and then this one right here, I added the pearl to it. So those are my cards for today. Like I said, this is a beautiful bundle. It's in the mini catalog, not guaranteed to be in the big one. So if this is something that you like I said, it could be used for anything. It could be used for a christening. It could be used for a wedding. It could be used for just a religious card, a get well, a sympathy card, just a beautiful card, absolutely gorgeous. So I hope you enjoyed my post for today. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm here to help. Take care and have a great day. Thank you.